Tonight is the sixth night of lights, and tonight I am changing gear and working a little bit with friendly plastic. This has been around for years and years and years. It's strips of thin plastic that are coated with color on one side, and Amoco is bringing them back. It's very, very lightweight, but I'm going to show you how to make it even a little bit lighter so that you can die cut this. So the first thing I'm going to do is lay my three colors together here. And take my Milwaukee gun, and we're going to zap this and heat it just a little bit here. I'm going to hold these together, and we're going to melt the steam together here. Once those seams have been melted together, I'm going to take another nonstick craft sheet, put over it, and I'm going to iron this. Again, my iron is set on the high cotton linen setting. I'm going to add some pressure because what I'm trying to do now is thin this out so it's going to spread out as I apply heat to it so I can get a thin enough piece that I can run it through a Sizzix die cut and get some really nice swirly embellishments out of this. It's going to take a few minutes here, so I'm going to put my camera on pause, and I'll come back when this is done. Okay, when that is cool and you take it up off the nonstick craft sheet, you can see the seams in it, but it's going to come together as one big, very thin piece of friendly plastic. And you can run that through the Sizzix. The steel roll dies just don't work, but the thicker Sizzix dies will work. And you can get some very pretty die cuts done. I love the swirl. That's one. Here's a different piece of plastic that I use for some flourishes. And then I have these two here that I really like. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to adhere them to canvas. But I also wanted to show you that you can just make any design you want. These are taken that thin, friendly plastic thin, and cut them in strips, and using a heat gun, I have melted them together and made a little Star of David here. So you can freeform any design you want as well. So the next thing we're going to do is lay our die cut on top of a piece of canvas that I've cut to the size of an ATZ, and I'm going to apply heat. Once again, I'm going to start out far and come in close and just let that start to melt a little bit. As you can see, that softens the edges of the die cut a little bit. We'll compare the two there, and it kind of rounds it up in the center. This is going to stay hot and for a little bit. I can stick things down in it, but before I do that, I want to position the star here where I want it. I thought I'd line it up about like that. Place that down on there. Then I'll melt this down into the canvas. And while this is still hot and fluid, I can then start adding little charms and bits and pieces into this wherever I want. So I'm going to put that little bead, I think, right in there and just press it down into the hot plastic. I've got a little pendant crystal here. I think we'll put that right in the center of this flourish up here. And then I have a butterfly that I want to attach here, but I don't really have anything to attach it to. So I'm going to bring in this other edge of a flourish here. And we're going to put it right here. We're going to melt it, and while I'm melting it, I'm going to bring the butterfly in. Okay, so I'm just going to position the butterfly here and press that down into it. And the ends of the swirl came off and they came back. So you can see you can do any kind of little collage work here that you want. I think I want something down in that corner, so I'll come back in a second. And so here's the final little ATC done with the friendly plastic and charms embedded in that. I want to get this up here so you can see the dimension on that. It can be quite chunky, but it can also be fairly thin. And this is just simply on plain white canvas background. But then I did another one where I used the Radiant Rains to give a little shimmer and color to a background. So I thought this was quite fun. You don't necessarily have to melt these into your plastic either. Taking that letter P that I did the other night, I haven't attached this yet, but you can see you could use this as a 3D embellishment and just pop a little die cut on the corner of this for a fun little look as well. This is the Six Minor Lights. I hope you've enjoyed it. Check for more information on my blog at jen-low-designs.blogspot.com. Thanks!